in the reality is called a rishi, seer. English we translate as seer. Seer of what? Not movie. Seer of the self. Seer of one's own supreme nature. He is called rishi. So such a realized master who is a rishi, Brahma Nirvanam Labhante, attains that state of moksha, Brahma Nirvan, when? After becoming totally free of all kalmasha. Kshina kalmashaha. Kalmash means impurities. All impurities of the mind. All the negativities of the mind. And it is not that it is something which one has to keep on cleaning continuously. The basic impurity of the mind is ignorance. Ignorance means not knowing our own self and assuming ourselves to be something and someone else. That is the basic impurity. On that alone is all other impurities are made. So the basic impurity itself gets negated through the right knowledge and then through the supreme experience, aparoksha anubhuti. So kshina kalmasha. In the beginning we can purify the mind to a certain extent to karma yoga and other sadhana, but then finally it becomes more pure to knowledge and then supremely pure after gaining that state of self-realization. So kshina kalmashaha, free from all kalmash, all impurities, chinnadvaidha, and free from all samshay, all doubts. Free from all doubts. As long as the doubt is there, our knowledge is not complete. See, we have knowledge of so many things, about especially in the field of spirituality, but it is also accompanied by little doubt, little or more. Doubt is there. Means complete conviction is not there. I am Brahma, this much knowledge by now we must have gained. But there is no conviction. First of all, that exact understanding of I and that Brahma, I as Brahma is not clear. And even if it is clear, some doubt as how can I be Brahma? What about this? What about that? And if I Brahma, I become Brahma, who will take care of my family? And so many little things are there. And I have become old now, if I become Brahma, what will happen? And before I become Brahma, let me write my will. So such silly little things might be there in the mind, but as we progress, maybe some more esoteric doubts can be there. More. Actually, from the question also, you come to know the level of the questioner. Like here we find that Arjuna's question also become more and more sublime as we progress in this Bhagavad Gita. Even the Upanishad, the questions of the questioners are very sublime. They are not just ordinary questions. So all our questions get dissolved, all our doubts get dissolved. Chinnas samshayaha we become. So chinnadvaidha, free from all samshay, all doubts. Because directly the person comes to comprehend the self, not indirectly. It's called aparoksha anubhuti. Aparoksha means without any media, free from any media. Where there is media, there is some gadbad. We know about the media. So media will have their own prejudices, own color of the truth. So some incident is there. And if you are hearing it through the media, seeing it through the media, they will add their own color, their own masala, namak, mirchi, ye wo dal ke, they show. So it is not as it is through the media. Similarly, at present we are experiencing the truth only, but through the media of our mind, of our intellect, of our desires, of our likes and dislikes, of our confusions. These are the media. So aparoksh anubhuti means free from all media, the experience of the self, by the self, in the self. No need of any media is required. Aparoksh. So that experience removes all doubt. Chinnadvaidha yatatmanaha, with his indriyas under control. The senses, the mind, absolutely in control. It doesn't move without his permission. At present, in the state of ignorance, the mind and senses move without taking our permission. We sit for meditation, and by the end of it, where the mind has gone, we don't know. Once Mullah Nasruddin was going on his donkey, and suddenly the donkey started running like anything. Donkeys, you never know, they have their own agenda. He started running. So someone asked Mullah that, where are you going in such a hurry? He said, why are you asking me? You ask my donkey. Stupid question you are asking me. You ask the donkey. Similarly, our mind is like the donkey. It runs. It has got its own agenda. It doesn't ask us. It doesn't take our permission. But a realized master is one whose mind will not move even one inch without his, because there is no motivation to move anywhere. There is no craving to move anywhere. There is nothing that mind can gain great so that it can move. It doesn't move in any place because there is no place which is so great that he has to go there. So when he has attained that Brahma Nirvana, the mind, the senses, the intellect remains in its own place. It moves only when it is required for some interaction and all, moves. Again it comes back to its place. Like Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi, if you ask him some question, he might speak, and then again he sits in his own state. So that is called free from yatatmanaha, complete control over the senses, the mind, the intellect. And sarva bhuta hite rataha, and they are engaged. Engaged means they are always in tune with the welfare of all beings. How? By being in a state of total non-violence, ahimsa. Being in the state of ahimsa, a realized master is not danger for anyone. It's like the water for the fish. The water is not danger for the fish. Different type of fish live in water. Some fish are very dangerous also, some are nice, sweet little fish. All of them are staying in water. They are neither afraid of water, nor the water is afraid of them. They live in total harmony. Similarly, a Mahatma is like water, and this world is like the fish moving around here and there. World doesn't have any fear from Mahatmas, and the Mahatma doesn't have fear from the world. So he is sarva bhuta hite rata, not proactively doing something, but the very presence of a realized master is a blessing for the whole world. So that is the great grand state, or great grand state of realization or enlightenment which we have to attain, which is shown here to all of us. Further, Bhagavan says, kama krodha viyuktanam yatinam yata chetasam abhito brahma nirvanam vartate viditatmanam काम क्रोध वियुक्तानां यतीनां यतचेतसां अभितो ब्रह्म निर्वाणं वर्तते विदितात्मन। अगेन द स्टेट ऑफ रियलाइजेशन इज पॉइंटेड आउट दैट दिस यति दिस रियलाइज्ड मास्टर इज काम क्रोध वियुक्तानाम हु इज फ्री फ्रॉम काम एंड क्रोध फ्री फ्रॉम काम क्रोध यत चेतसाम हुज अंतकरण इज अंडर हिज कंट्रोल विदितात्मनाम हु हैज रियलाइज और हु हैज गेन द नॉलेज ऑफ हिज ओन सेल्फ सच यति ब्रह्म निर्वाणम वर्तते फॉर हिम देर इज दिस ब्रह्म निर्वाण मोक्ष वेर अभितः एट ऑल टाइम्स वाइल द बॉडी इज देर एंड इवन वेन द बॉडी फॉल्स ऑफ दे आर इन अ स्टेट ऑफ मोक्ष ओनली काम क्रोध वियुक्तानाम दे बिकम फ्री ऑफ काम एंड क्रोध सी इग्नोरेंस इज द बेसिक इम्प्योरिटी दैट इग्नोरेंस अलोन क्रिएट the other dosha like kama and krodha and the desire for happiness desire for seeking pleasure desire to repeat this pleasure again and again going out in through our mind through our senses to seek pleasure is that kama and when that pleasure is not attained when there are obstacles when some problems are there then we get irritated and that is our krodha so this is the favorite pastime of an ignorant person seeking pleasure constantly and getting annoyed when that pleasure is not gained and when that pleasure is gained greed comes I want more because that pleasure however great doesn't satisfy us always it leaves another desire to have more that is a very strange thing about these pleasures that it doesn't we feel don't feel completely what you call fulfilled but again another desire comes in Mahabharata elsewhere I give an example that it is like fire the more you put fuel in that fire the more it burns it doesn't get satiated by the fuel it feels that oh fire is there let me just put some fuel and then it will become all right no it wants more it demands more it demands more even if the woods of the whole world is put in fire the fire will still demand more that is a great strange thing about fire so our desires are like this fire and fulfilling the desire is like putting fuel the more it wants it never because it is seeking infinity so it can never be satisfied with the finite and infinity is gained only by attaining that self not by any other thing of this world so even if one gains swarga prapti and special pleasures of that swarga still that mind will not be satisfied even the devatas and all they are not satisfied according to the stories which we read in puranas and all even the devatas even indra bhagwan who is the king of all the devatas who has got all the pleasures in his hand but he is also not satisfied so pleasures alone cannot satisfy a person and through pleasure we are seeking lasting happiness but lasting happiness is not there in the very mechanism of gaining that pleasure it comes through contact of the object and the contact doesn't last long and when it loses the pleasure also goes away so kama and krodha are associated therefore in third chapter we saw both bhagwan says is the cause of our papa so kama when it is not fulfilled when it is obstructed then the same that energy